Will the first gold medal of the 2022 World Judo Championships go to Natsumi Tsunoda, the cat Funa Tanaki, or perhaps there will be a surprise in store? This has been a division that has long been dominated by the Japanese players, and in this video we'll be looking over some of their best moments, and I'll give you my predictions of who I think is going to win, and I hope you'll give me yours in the comments. The French judo team had the choice of fielding two judokas in this category. Even though Marie Clermont is ranked number two in the world in IJF rankings, they have chosen not to send her. They do not believe she's a strong chance of winning a gold medal because of the dominance of the Japanese players in this division. So Funa Tanaki was the Olympic silver medalist, and in this video I'm going to be talking a little bit about how much she's changed her style. Her style is now very different to the style she used at the last Olympics. So France will be sending the world number one, Shirane Bokley. She's previously met Natsumi Tsunoda one time before, and things did not end well for her. She got trapped in a jujigatame. So the very tall Daria Beladid, 172 centimeters, was the main challenge for the 148 centimeter Funa Tanaki. She beat Tanaki over and over again, and then in 2021, Tanaki turned the tables on her, beat her two times, and Tanaki's style at this point was to try to get her tsurate, her lead hand on the collar, force Daria into a bent over stance. And she has changed the style since then. I'll be showing later on how the style of Funa Tanaki has changed. Here is Natsumi Tsunoda against Krasniqi of Kosovo. At the World Championships last year, Tsunoda threw her twice, both times with beautiful tomoanages. Now, to Krasniqi's credit, she did come back at the Olympics and was pretty spectacular there. Krasniqi has a record of two wins, two losses against Tsunoda. Her record against Tanaki is the same. Now notice how she uses the grip on the back of Tanaki, which is over the top of Tanaki's arm while Tanaki's trying to use standard tsurate grips. And Tanaki was caught again and again with this uchimata, so she was thrown three times in their rivalry with that over the back grip uchimata. Now Natsumi Tsunoda has only one loss to a non-Japanese judoka that is currently active in the 48 kilo category, and it's to this woman, Julia Figueroa of Spain. So Figueroa is physically very similar to Funa Tanaki. They're almost the same size, and being so short does make it difficult for Natsumi Tsunoda to use her favorite attack, which is the tomoanage. It's difficult for the taller player to get under the shorter player to get into the tomoanage position, and shorter players tend to be more agile. So Figueroa is able to use some athleticism to avoid being scored on. So this match was mostly going the way of Natsumi Tsunoda. Little lucky not to be called for a standing joint lock there. Finally, Figueroa, unusual variation of Kataguruma, pull up the big win. That was in 2019. Funatanaki has defeated Julia Figueroa three times. The most recent victory was a few months ago in Budapest. Here's a look at Funatanaki versus Shirane Bokley. So notice Bokley prefers to go for this over the back grip, somewhat similar to Krasniqi. Bokley does have pretty strong turning throws, but not as precise, in my opinion, as Krasniqi. But she does also like to go for the sumigaishi. You can see how Funatanaki is using standard gripping here with the tsurute and sleeve. She's really having trouble getting into position on Bokley. She can't quite close that distance, somewhat similar to her matches with Krasniqi. Now, something really good that Bokley's doing in this match is she's going for the sumigaishi and then she's popping right back up. So the French women have a habit of falling victim to the Japanese on the ground. Bokley's doing the right thing by getting back to her feet as soon as possible. Here it comes. Bokley scores with Waza-ari with that sumigaishi. The reason she was able to win with that sumigaishi was she was able to block Tanaki's left hand. So the left hand couldn't protect Tanaki. We'll have a look in a moment at what Tanaki would have liked to have done from this sumigaishi. On the right side, you can see Tanaki against Munkbat, facing out with the left hand. She's able to come on top in the sumigaishi. Now here's a 2022 look at Funatanaki dealing with someone going for an over-the-back grip. And one thing to notice about all of her 2022 throws is she's not using standard gripping. She's not using standard collar sleeve grips. She's using much closer gripping techniques. She's basically going hip to hip, front on with her opponents. Sometimes she's throwing a hand directly over the back. And sometimes she's using high collar grip. And she's also tilting herself to one side to force her opponent into reaching over so she can access the belt grip. You can see from that one there that she tilted her body to the right side, so Koga had to reach over to the left side, and that opened up the space so she could grab Koga's belt and throw her. Natsumi Tsunoda has also dominated the world number three ranked Wakana Koga of Japan. Here she defeated her with Juji Gatame. And we'll have a look at how Natsumi Tsunoda is able to use her mobility to avoid the Tomoanage Jujigatame combination. So rather than trying to circle away from the Tomoanage, she's trying to move her back leg out of the way, and it's forcing Tsunoda into a weaker position. Here we see Utarabe. She's going more head-on into the Tomoanage. She got off-balanced and then got caught in Jujigatame. And in a moment, we'll have a look at Funatanaki dealing with a Tsunoda Tomoanage when she's more head-to-head, just able to sprawl the leg back, and she immediately gets into a position where she can deadlift Tsunoda. Here's Utarabe getting thrown again with Tomoanage. This time lands directly on her head. And I'm going to have a look at Tonaki get elevated, but she's able to quickly recover base and put Natsumi Tsunoda into defensive positions. A lot of these Tomoanage attempts from Tsunoda were a little weak. She was very desperate to get into the Tomoanage position. She might have to be careful she's not called for a false attack during the final match. Now that's a nice Kosodo Gari, one of Tsunoda's best weapons. And here we get to see Funatanaki get into her favorite position, that belt grip, and this time Tsunoda was side on and she was able to avoid Kosodo Gari or Taniotoshi attempt. But later in the match, Tsunoda was caught. See how Tonaki forced Tsunoda's arm across, so she had to go for that same side grip. That's the position she wants to be in to launch her Ochigari. Now, Boakley has a very interesting choke. She turns people over using this Sode Guruma Jime. Here she switches from a failed Huzinga roll attempt into the Sode Guruma Jime. Then she steps the leg over the head, sits to her back, and the choke is applied. It forces the opponent to roll. In this case, Osaikomi was not called because the leg of Boakley, the right leg, was across the upper back. They don't call Osaikomi if the leg is across the upper back. So the opponent had to submit. So my predictions, this is my odds for who I think's going to win. So a complete outsider, someone ranked between, say, 12 and 40. There's 40 women in this tournament. I give a complete outsider a chance of 1% of coming away with gold. The most dangerous outsiders, I think, would be the Chinese. They have very good newaza, but they don't compete on the IJF tour a lot. They're an unknown quantity. Another player from the top 11 that's not Boakley, Tsunoda, or Tonaki, I give that a 5% chance. Boakley, I've been pronouncing it wrong the whole video. Boakley is a 10% chance, in my opinion. She's got the big throws. She was able to beat Belotted and Tonaki, so she can handle the pressure against the big players, even though she was a bit of a disappointment in last year's Worlds and Olympics, where she went out in the first round at the Olympics and the second round at Worlds. I'm going to give Funatanaki a 40% chance of taking home gold. I'm a little bit worried about how she matches up against Boakley. I think she's got a pretty good chance against Tsunoda, maybe a slight favorite in a head-to-head matchup against Tsunoda, but only slightly. And I think Tsunoda's a big favorite against Boakley or anybody else in this field. So I'm going to give Sonoda a 44% chance of winning gold. So those are my odds. Please let me know in the comments who you think is going to take home the gold medal. I'll be back for more videos during the World Championships. Subscribe for more non-stop Nawaza.